ओम ब्रह्मानंदम परम सुखदम केवलम ज्ञानमूर्तिम द्वंद्वातीतम त्रिगुणरहितम तस्मस्यादिलक्ष्यम एकम नित्यम विमलमचलम सर्वदिशाक्षिहुतम भावातीतम त्रिगुणरहितम सद्गुरुं तं नमामि। ओम गुरु ब्रह्मा गुरु विष्णु गुरु देवो महेश्वरः गुरु साक्षात् परब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरुवे नमः। ध्यानमूलं गुरुमूर्ति पूजामूलं गुरुपदं मंत्रमूलं गुरुर्वाक्यं मोक्षमूलं गुरुकृपा। सद्गुरु भगवान की जय। स्वामी जी महाराज की जय। शिवोहम। वी आर टेकिंग द 21 स्टेंजा ऑफ चैप्टर 7 श्रीमद् भगवद गीता। यो यो याम याम तनु भक्तः श्रद्धार्चितु मिच्छति तस्य तस्याचराम श्रद्धां तामेव विद्धान्यं तामेव विद धाम्यहम्। यह यह याम याम तनुम भक्तः श्रद्धा अर्चितुम इच्छति तस्य तस्य अचलाम श्रद्धाम ताम एव विदधामि अहम्। यह यह दोष दोष भक्ता इट मीन्स द praying with the desire, worship with the desire, yam yam, these, tanum, tanum it means god or goddess form, sraddhaya it means with the respect with this that god and goddess, architam it means worship, ichchati and it means he want to do the worship. Thus it means that tasya tasya us that bhakta sraddham it means his internal respect aham it means aham it means I achalam it means I fix vidadham it means I am fixing that the respect of the particular god and goddess. Those the worshipper who worship the god and goddess with a desire or bunch of desires and he want to worship that god and goddess, the Krishna is telling I give him the stability of respect with that god and goddess, because Krishna's already tell in 20 stanza that his consciousness is kidnapped by the sensory hunger. The Satchidananda Paramatma, Lord Krishna, who is the only and only the base and installation of universes, billions of galaxies, is telling in this stanza about that blind person. They are not interested to know in themselves, they are not interested to know Atma Sakshatkara, they are not interested to enlightenment. So what is happened in the 20 stanza already said, it is the complement of 20 stanza. Krishna has said that if they are not bound to me and they all flowing in the desires of the senses, so the consciousness is totally kidnapped by the sensory hungers. Now what happened? Then they want to worship the particular god and goddess. for the sakama bhakti, for the particular desire fulfilling, so what can I do? It is only one way, that I am living in his body. I cannot live, I cannot give him death. Do as he desire, I give the faith in that God and Goddess do. I have remember a joke. Today I read in internet when I was on Facebook. A teacher asked the child that, do you pray the God, Mohan? So Mohan answered, no teacher, I do not pray, but my mother pray. So teacher asked, very good, what pray your mother? Mother pray, thank God, this devil is now sleeping, I am feeling relief. So if a child is very notorious and very problematic, his mother feel relief when he is sleeping. So like that they are child. They do not want to aware into the God. They are very notorious. They doing meaningless activities. So God think, do as you want. Do as you want. God feel that do not need to teach them. Do as they want to do. This is joke is similar for this shloka. Now I think that God give me this joke today morning. So it is the shloka is telling tanum bhaktaha. Tanum bhakta, it means the devotee of the physical body. You see, the blind person, they are very conscious to their physical body. They never care about the qualities of internal goodness, never care. They only care the quality of the physical body. Two head, they want to look beautiful. So they go in the massage parlors. So they bring the beautiful cream, Garnier cream and other cream and Pond's cream and Lakme cream and that sense. So they use the creams, even the men or women both. They use the lotions on the body. They shave the hair all over his body. Even the men or women, they have the hair on the body. They use the particular process to remove their hair. And they take the very nice hairstyle and lipstick and chipstick and other and other and other. The day-to-day life, they expend the money and time, precious time, to maintain their body. Even they don't know how to bath. They are foolish person. They leave some part of body without cleaning, so they face the problem also after some time. But they are very conscious to body, so this is called Tanur Bhakta. They are the devotees of their physical body. And what type of Tanur Bhakta do? They think that the physical body is only truth and other is the illusion and other is the hypothetical imaginary things. They think that all are philosophy and it is true. Physical body is true. So this is the sack of different type of dirty things putting in the physical body. They think this physical body is great. Somebody of you have seen the animal that the leather worker, they put out the leather of the dead animals. You see that animals very hating. Red is the flesh and bones and others. Like if your skin not present your body, your physical body is very ugly. But they do not know that physical body is ugly. They think that physical body is the top class thing. And they give argument also. So, I remember my master's speech. My master told of why the physical body worshipped. In the ancient time, nobody worshipped the idols, or nobody worshipped the physical body. But there was a person, the philosopher, that is name is Charvak, and he given a theme. That theme was, if you want to enjoy your life, you must owe the money from others and drink and eat and be merry, and who will be return the money when you dead? Who will be return your money when you dead? You take money from others, you owe money others, you take loans from others and drink and eat and live lavishly. He say that there is nothing rebirth. This is your last birth. You eat, drink and marry. So this type of thinking make the brain blunt. This type of thinking make the door closed for enlightenment. So this thinking come in the devil Birochan. Birochan was a Rakshasa, he was the devil. He was the grandfather of the Prahlada, he was the father, forefather of Hiranyakashyapa. That Birochan has starting the worship of idols. He make his himself idols. He make his himself idols and make the temples of himself. Then after this, worship start and it is modified. Then in the place of the devil's idols, there is comes the idols of Vishnu and other. So they think that God is a physical body, but they are wrong because they do not know about the real existence and real form of the God. The real existence and real form of the God is Gita is discovering that Jivasya Jivanoham Aham Atma Gunakesha Sarvbhutatajatmani. The real form of the God is your Atma. That is the existence, that is the real form of the God. But the less of divine intellect person, they do not know, as the 20th stanza Krishna says, hata jnanaha, because their jnana, their knowledge, their divinity are kidnapped by the sensory hungers. If a person is very hungry and you are telling good things and you are giving the teaching, his all attention to the food, he is very thirsty, he want to drink, and he will not hear your teaching because his all energy is flowing toward the food. If a person is newly in love with a girl and you are telling the good divine stories in front of them, he will think that when your story will be stopped and he will be go to meet his girlfriend. So his energy is flowing to the kama, to the sex energy. And if a person is very miser, he do not want to give the money to anyone, and you are teaching them the big heart and sacrifice and sacrification and give the money and do the good work, he will think inside, you are fool. Why I give the money? I will enjoy my money. So this type of persons, they are Tanun Bhakta, they never heard Sadguru. They never heard the enlightened person, they never heard the master, they never hear the teaching, they never adopt the teaching, they never they never adopt the teaching of Gita and Ramayana and Upanishads. They need their own books, the novels. They need the romantic stories. They need the romantic films. They need the good wine and five-star hotel dinner. They want to dance in the pubs. They want to dance in the discotheques. They want to go on the beaches. They want to go to Thailand. They want to Thai massage. They want to eat the seafood. They want to enjoy their life. They do not want to enlighten. They do not want to know the truth. They will kick out your truth. Because their intellect is not developed. So the Krishna is tell in that 19th shloka that in the last birth, in the 19th shloka, Krishna is tell in the last birth, he can worship me correctly. Because without knowing the jnana, nobody can not worship correctly of existence God. So they are living in the minus, not living, even they are not living in the zero. They are below the zero persons. So the below the zero persons, as a child very notorious in our family, we feel the relief when the child sleep. And the zero, below to zero, the negative person, as a Kumbhakarna, as a Ravana, as a Kansa, as Duryodhana, as the Kaurava, there is only and only one way, that by the Rama came, Krishna came and destroyed them from the earth. They cannot be turned out, they cannot be changed, they cannot be transformed, they cannot be make their life nice. Only one way, leave them and do as they want to do. So Krishna is telling in this stanza, yo yo yam yam tanum bhaktaha, those person, as their method, they are worshipping the different type of god and goddess for their fulfilling the desires, for their fulfilling the needs, for their own illusions and or imaginations and on the rules and regulation to the prayer and the worship, I do not disturb them. Even tasya tasya chala sriddha, even what I do, I give them energy, because the energy comes from the God. I give them energy for the concrete confidence about that false God and Goddess. Because I know they will be not turned to me. I know they cannot be transformed. I know they are living in very, very negative stage, the millions of miles away from the real seekers. They are millions of miles behind from the real seeker. I remember a short story in the Kapilvastu, Nepal, when the Buddha want to go for his last journey to know the God existence for Buddhatva, he was leaving his big mansion. He was coming out by the steps. There is many, many steps Buddha is coming out. And just at that time, a beggar was going to that mansion for begging something in the morning by the king. So Buddha is coming out and the beggar was coming in. After some walking distance, when Buddha is came, middle part of that steps, and the beggar is also stand the same step of the Buddha, and both are stay for a while there. I want to ask a question. That beggar and Buddha was the physically in the same stage, but they are same stage? Yes or no? No. The Buddha was leaving all the treasures. The Buddha was leaving all the sensory hungers. The Buddha was leaving all the desires. The Buddha was leaving his emperor. Buddha was leaving his richness. Buddha was leaving the Maya. Buddha was going towards the journey for enlightenment. He is going to know the existence. But the beggar is very hungry. The beggar was Sakama Bhakta. The beggar has desires. He is going to beg some money and goods and etc. So these type of person who do not do the meditation, who do not the consciousness to knowing existence inside, they are like beggars. They are like beggars. And no emperor like to sit in equal to the beggars. So God reject them and God ignore them and God leave them on their stage. And God, because the God existence is living in everybody, every living beings, so God is great merciful. He not leave them, but he give them the energy for doing this false activity, because God knows this thing, that his creation, everything in his creation, in God's creation, even a light and dark also. In the God's creation, there is a water, but there is stone also. In God the creation, there is a flower, but there is pine also. In the God creation, there is the melodious aromas and there is bad smelling also. Every adverse thing is in this nature. So, it is the choice of the human birth, what you want to choose. And a very, very nice thing is that when a master see that he is giving the discourse to his disciples, but they are not accepting his teachings as well, then after some time the master also ignored that disciple, and then he leave the disciple on his own will. So like this, the God pushing that type of living being who is not respect the presence inside of the God. He is respecting the outside idols and outside God and Goddess. Then God give him the faith about that God and Goddess. And God think that do as you want. It is our duty to tell in front of you truth. This Gita is telling the truth about all the humanity. But those person who want to enlighten aware, they can come in the path of the liberation. And they, if some person they don't want to liberate, so they can do as they want. If you cannot give the new sight of eyes to blind person, please do not snatch his stick which is helping him to walking. If you cannot build up a big house, a good house, the cemented roof, house for a poor person, please do not dismantle his hut. He is leaving the hut, he is satisfied. So if you are worship your God and Goddess, if you are satisfied, who I am to oppose you? You do as you want, but the Sadguru, the Master, the enlightened person, only speak for those persons, they are seekers, or they are artha, or they are tharthi. Only for he is giving the discourse. So my dear friends, give me the pardon if you feel some painful thing in my speech, my discourse. Give me the pardon if my discourse is not liking by you, because it is only for my lovers, seekers, disciples. It is not for all. It is for a special person. And Krishna is telling like that. If you are faith in any God and Goddess, I will complete your faith. I will give empower your faith. You do as you want, because you do not want to me. I am living inside of you, but you are ignoring me. So how can I say you come to me? Because I know you will not come to me. So this type of persons, they are living in full unconsciousness. There is nothing possible to aware them. If your journey from many births will give you the ability of awareness, then only for those able person the Master came on the earth. Thank you very much.